We have a terrific panel this morning addressing a topic of great interest on at least two dimensions, because we're looking at the intersections of the immigration crisis brought about by new policies out of Washington, and what it means for higher education, which has become increasingly dependent for a variety of reasons and in a variety of ways on the mobility of students across borders. We were, in the fall of 2016, at an all-time high of international students coming to the United States, over a million studying in this country. And we're beginning to see the signs that those numbers are rolling back.
And I think one of the things that we saw, as just an example, after the first Muslim ban executive order and some of the chaos that happened at the airports, many of the people who were caught up in being detained and being impacted by that are certainly were students. There were students from the CUNY system. There were a number of different foreign-born students who were coming back to the United States to resume their studies, and they got caught up in the airports, not just here in New York, but elsewhere. We've also seen a spike in, frankly, hate crimes and other sort of violence against immigrants. And so now some of the news that you're hearing from other parts of the world is, should we be sending folks to the United States? Kind of, has the climate become so much more toxic? And that's a big problem for us, right? Both because so many immigrants come here and make tremendous economic contributions.
I have, you know, friends at professors at other universities in other countries who are saying, you know, we were going to send people, you know, we're talking about Baruch and other places, but I'm not sure. You know, what do you think? Should we send people there? You know, will they be safe? Will they be able to get home? Will they get arrested or pulled over or profiled? And the answers I would have given a few months ago are not the same answers I'd given now. There's a great deal of uncertainty, and uncertainty undermines trust.
There is a tremendous amount of fear. It's something that I see in my classroom. I teach a course on immigration. If you look at my classroom, I have a lot of different folks. I think I would say maybe 60 to 70% are immigrants or the direct descendants of immigrants, and it's very palpable in discussions that we have. So I think we're up against a formidable challenge to convince people that this is still a safe and good place to come and pursue your education, and that, you know, I would hope that we would try to retain this talent, but given, you know, the changes in discussions about H-1B.
You have to be honest about what the circumstances are on the ground. And I think that honesty will do a lot going forward to convince institutional partners that we have their best interests and their students' best interests at heart.